Well, after about, what, 2 years of inactivity?
Yeah, a couple years.
The Cortland Roller Rink is back in action, and it's under new ownership with Sean Tassone. And, like, the Champion roller skating rink burnt down.
Yeah, a little over a year ago. It was, I think, Christmas Eve, maybe, last year.
So this is the only skating in Trumbull County.
Yes, you are correct.
And, boy, is this a popular place.
Yeah, not bad for a Saturday afternoon.
Now, Sean, what do you know about running a roller skating rink?
You're looking at it. I've done it for 1 month. I have absolutely no clue what I'm doing, but I'm having a blast. So good news is I got people that have been around roller skating forever working here.
That's right. I mean, you've got to go with the professionals.
That's right.
So what led you to buy it? So it was for sale?
The rink was for sale, and I had a real estate agent looking around for property for me because I had just sold a building, and I needed to do a like-kind exchange. So this was the right size. I came up and looked at it, thought, what could it be? Open up the doors, I go, this has to stay a roller rink. So now we're in the roller skating business.
You've really done a lot of upgrades.
Yeah, and we're not done yet. So it's too much fun. It was, I mean, the building had good bones, I call it. You know, it was solid, it's a good structure, brick building, but it was everything was 45 years old. So we just had to rip everything out and start from scratch. I mean, as far as the interior.
The flooring.
New carpet, new ceiling, all the new lighting. And this is the first step of it.
What is this floor size?
This floor is, it's a competition floor, they call it. So it's 180 foot long by 80 foot wide. So it's one of the biggest in the country. There's not as many skating rinks left anymore. I would say, I think they're down to 1,600. Because if you think about it, it was real popular in the 70s and 80s.
Yeah.
And the average owner now is probably 70-ish years old.
Yeah.
And the kids would rather sell this out to a grocery store or a Rite Aid or a church and just have it done instead of operating a rink.
I don't remember there being referees. What do you call them?
They're skate guards. And they're out there in case anybody would fall down or need assistance. They help the young kids learn how to skate. They're there in case there's a spill, you know, anything. They're kind of just watching out.
You don't have to have like a lifeguard certificate or a skate guard certificate.
No, they take some sort of test, I think, through the RSA, the Roller Skating Association.
But, and you're a member?
Oh, gosh.
In good standing?
I paid the dues. I did. And I learned all about music. You coming from the radio, I had to pay those dues up. So that's, to play the music in here. Hey, this guy, we're getting photobombed over here.
You're loafing on the job.
Yeah, he is loafing. You're right.
That's right. Yep, there you go. I'm just happy people are coming out. I didn't know when I was building this place out, I'm like, I hope this works out. Because it could have been a storage facility real quick.
I think, and especially, opening up during COVID and, the pandemic.
And we're following all the mandates there are. You notice when you come in, you have to get your temperature taken. There's sanitizing stations all through here. You try to do your best you can to follow a 6-foot rule. It's a little tough on the skates, but there's pretty good separation out there.
But it's considered exercise.
That's why you see no masks on the participants.
Tell you, after a couple rounds, I would have had a hard time keeping a mask on because you really do work up a
There's
sweat.
No doubt about it.
Yeah.
And here's the good part. Like, you see, some have it on, some don't. If you want to wear a mask, wear your mask.
It's funny. These kids are crazy.
They don't stop. It's just fun to see people smiling and having fun again. And I think that's why we're having such a good time right now is everybody's been penned up for a year. These kids have energy. They got to get it out. So come on up and skate.
What I remember is I don't remember if we skated to popular music. I think the guy was always playing the organ.
He might have been.
I don't remember that. Now, there was like a perch in Boardman.
That's right, there was.
And he would be out there, the Wizard of Oz. And I'm wondering, I see that you have an organ.
Yeah, to kind of keep the past alive, I created kind of a mini museum, a little memorabilia section.
Now, is that organ working?
It does to a point. And we thought about having an organist in for certain, different sessions. The purists, if you will, the real roller skaters.
Yes.
We have this adult, they call it adult skate, but it's kind of like 70 plus. They've been doing it forever. they like that because they skate to the beat of the organ, like the different chords. They don't like all this, you know, new music. And I tell you what, the most fun though seems to be like 80s, 90s. Like everybody's, it's retro. We, even though everything's modern, I try to keep that retro thing. When
exactly.
we skated in your St. Christine's parties or Canfield, and you know, and so like all the games and everything I put in here are all, there's stuff that we would have played. So if somebody brings their kid, they can play against them. Like, hey, I'll take you on and, you know, skee ball, because they played skee ball. There's so many things to do here. It's just a big building that's wide open.
I mean,
and it's
it
fun.
Sounds like you have got some excellent ideas.
Well, hopefully I'm going to make her help me get some bands in here on Thursday nights.
Like, we're going to start music?
Yeah, we want to start adult night on Thursdays now that the curfew lifted.
Thirsty Thursday.
That's right.
Well, I'm sure that Cortland is thrilled to have this building occupied.
What a great town. I'm from Mahoning County. I grew up in Canfield, live in Boardman now. This Cortland is such a good community. I mean, people are really, really just genuinely good folks. And the draw is actually a little bit even bigger than that, though. I mean, roller skate, people drive up a half hour easy, but we've had them. Detroit's been here, Erie, Pittsburgh, Cleveland.
I was they're coming. With a lot of Pennsylvania, a lot over the state
line.
A lot,
you know, the other states are a little tougher, you know, on the rules to let people engage, you know, in having skating. So we're catching others. But really, most of it's, you know, Trumbull County. And you know, great folks.
The Casey Malone Show will be right back with more local flavor.